So you have an event coming up in April, right? Tell us a little bit more about the event, what the audience will see when they come. I know you mentioned earlier that you're going to have what, three production lines, I think, on the floor, two with tools running production. Yeah, tell us about the event coming up in April.
So we're very excited for the event. We've branded the event the Brewer Tech Expo, and it's going to be a 3-day event from April 16th to the 18th. From an equipment standpoint, we're going to have all of the latest Brewer technology on display. And a few of them, as you mentioned, will be running production. A few press lines will be running tooling and will demonstrate, the complete system, so to speak. We're also going to be displaying all of the latest peripheral equipment, from lubricating and cleaning to inspection, material handling, all of the things that would go around the Brewer presses in a normal production environment. As you also know, we have some additional partners that we deal with from around the world. For example, Invernese, they are a producer of transfer presses out of Italy. They all have a machine here. SBT out of Austria, they make complex manufacturing systems. They're going to have a small machine here producing medical clips. And we're going to have I think we're going to have three or four different welding machines here. And we're going to basically do welding seminars with our customer, demonstrating how we can weld the strip and also the finished stamped product. So it's going to be a very busy show. For sure.
Yeah, sounds good. Sounds good.
From a Brewer standpoint, we will have the brand new BSTL 350 that we previously discussed. That will be here. It's going to be its America's debut. That'll be running a production tool. We're going to have a 510 150, which is going to be equipped with three of the BSA servo axes and also a BSV 170 servo feed. That machine is going to be set up to really demonstrate the capabilities of the BSA servo axis. So it won't be running production, but it'll have the three servo motors set up on the bolster plate, all performing different functions so that customers can get an idea of how that technology plays into the production process.
Okay.
And we're going to have an BSTA 810-180, a big machine, 80-ton machine, also an integrated Brewer 300 servo feed. We're looking for a big die to come in for that, but it's not certain yet, so we have our fingers crossed.
All right.
And we'll have two 10-ton mini Brewers, one servo-driven and one standard mechanical-driven. Be running a small die in one of those machines. And as I mentioned, Invernese will be here with a 60-ton transfer press. It's a 14-station transfer press with a blank and cup feature. And SBT is going to have a mini stamper on site producing small medical clips. We are also incorporating our friends from San Giacomo. They're going to have a couple of little presses here. What they are, we're not exactly certain of yet, but probably 20-ton and a 40-ton, something small.
Okay.
So that's the
Sounds like,
equipment side.
yeah, sounds like a lot of equipment to see. That's fantastic. And then you'll also have some technical presentations, right? Along with
Yep.
the equipment on display. So what are some of the topics that'll be covered during the technical presentations?
Right. It's a great question. This is a very important part, in my opinion, of the overall Tech Expo. We're going to do presentations. From the Brewer side, we're going to cover the latest trends in high-speed stamping. Stepper from Germany has agreed to come over. They're sending their head of R&D over, Martin Hess. He's going to do a presentation on maintenance-free, high-performance progressive dies, which is going to be, in my opinion, a highlight. That's going to talk a lot about creative ways to build, these high performance, larger progressive dies so that you don't have as many maintenance issues with them. It's going to be a great presentation. Otto Vision Systems coming over also from Germany. They're going to talk about advancements in inline inspection, focusing on their newest technologies, which are laser cut weld systems and laser marking systems, which operate on the fly with the press line. They use a laser to cut out the bad part and reattach the strip. And then their laser marking, identification numbers, and whatever on the parts, really neat stuff. RL automation, we'll be talking about coating, cleaning, and preserving with modern day environmental considerations. Another interesting topic. We're all struggling a little bit with that.
Mm-hmm.
Invernese will be here to talk about transfer technology. SBT is going to provide a presentation on their stamped, formed, and welded assemblies. And Wintrus Controls is going to be here talking about new advancements in die protection and cam features. So we have a schedule that we're going to publish. It's already partly published, and it's going to be updated. But some of the presentations will be daily, and some will alternate, whether it's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So people will have to determine what day they want to come based on what presentation they want to be a part of.
Sure. Okay.
And then from a social standpoint, I'll just add that we're going to, we're going to set this up as a really nice, going to have a nice environment. Great place for everyone to meet, not only with all of the suppliers that'll be here, but for our customers to mingle with each other. We're going to theme the days based on a lot of the suppliers that'll be there. We're going to have a Swiss day, a German day, an Italian day. So the catering will be, set up to follow those themes, and it'll be a fun time. And then on Friday, the day when the show's over, we're going to have an employee day. We're going to do an American day, and all of our employees and their families will be invited to come in and see the equipment. So it's going to be a good time. We're looking forward to it.
Yeah, it sounds like a terrific event. So much to offer. So finally, AJ, so how can the folks watching this learn more about the event, how to register, and maybe see the schedule when it's completed?
So there's going to be detailed information on our website. We're marketing the show through Metalforming, not only obviously in print, but also in digital mediums. We're using all of the available social media outlets, and people, we're going to do everything we can to make sure as many people know about it as possible. But from our website and from all of the marketing materials, you're going to be able to get detailed information on all of the presentations that are going to be happening, the days of the show, the times. Everything will be made available. So should be pretty easy for people to register for the show and set up their trip and whatever else they need.
Yeah, fantastic. And what's the website again?
It's brooderamericas.com.
Brooderamericas.com. Terrific. AJ, thanks for joining us and for sharing all that great info and telling us about the event. We will look forward to seeing you in April.
Thanks, Brad. I appreciate the time. I look forward to hopefully seeing you in April when here for the show.
Yeah, we'll be there.
All right, great.
Yep, take care.
Thank you. Bye-bye.